Welcome to a lesson on evaluating algebraic expressions. An expression in which some or all of the terms contain variables is an algebraic expression or a variable expression. If the value of the variables is known, we can evaluate the expression. So to evaluate an algebraic or variable expression, we substitute the value of the variables into the expression and then evaluate using the order of operations. So for example, if we have the expression 5x minus 12, and we're also given that x equals 17, we replace the variable x with the value of 17, and then evaluate the expression. So here we'd have 5 times 17 minus 12. Well, 5 times 17 is 85, and then 85 minus 12 is equal to 73. Let's go ahead and review the order of operations before we do a few more examples. So remember, there are four steps to the order of operations. Number one, we'll evaluate inside the parentheses or grouping. Number two, we'll evaluate the exponents. Number three, we'll multiply and divide from left to right as it occurs. And number four, we'll add and subtract from left to right. So let's go ahead and look at several examples. So here we're given that x equals negative 3, y equals 7, and z equals negative 2, and we want to evaluate x minus 3y plus 7. Well, x is equal to negative 3, so we'll have negative 3 plus 3 times y, but y is 7, plus 7. Now we'll follow the order of operations, so we'll multiply first. 3 times 7 would be 21, so we have negative 3 plus 21 plus 7. And now we just add from left to right, so negative 3 plus 21, that would be 18. Plus 7 equals 25. This next example, it's the same process. We have 2 times x squared, but x is now negative 3, plus 5 times y, y is 7, minus z to the third power, and z is equal to negative 2. And so now we'll evaluate this using the order of operations. There's nothing we can do inside the parentheses, so next we'll take a look at the exponents. Negative 3 squared would be positive 9. And negative 2 raised to the third power would be equal to negative 8. Now we'll go ahead and multiply. So 2 times 9 is equal to 18, plus 5 times 7 is equal to 35. Now here we have minus negative 8, and that'll become plus positive 8. And now performing the addition from left to right, we have 18 plus 35 plus 8. 18 plus 35 would be 53, plus 8 would be 61. Now we have y equals positive 2, and we want to evaluate this expression here. So we replace y with positive 2. Next, there's no parentheses that we can simplify. There's no exponents, so we will multiply and divide now from left to right. Now here we have a fraction. This does mean 9 divided by 2. So it really depends if we want to have our final answer in fraction form or decimal form. Let's go ahead and rewrite this in decimal form. So 9 divided by 2 would be 4.5 minus 8 times 2, that's 16. Plus 2. And now we'll perform the addition and subtraction from left to right. So we have 4.5 minus 16. It's going to be negative 11.5 plus 2, which equals negative 9.5. If we wanted this in fraction form, that would be the same as negative 9 1/2, or we could write this as negative 19/2, all of which are equivalent, just in different forms. Here we have x equals 3 and y equals negative 5, so we'll have 4 times x, which is 3, minus 3 times y squared, but y is negative 5, so we'll have negative 5 squared. Next we'll evaluate negative 5 squared. That'll be 4 times 3 minus 3 times negative 5 squared is positive 25. Now we'll multiply. So 3 times 4 would be 12, minus 3 times 25 is equal to 75. And then finally, 12 minus 75 is equal to negative 63. And let's try another. Here we have x equals negative 2, so we'll substitute negative 2 in for x. So we'll have 3 times negative 2 to the third power minus negative 2 squared plus 2 times negative 2 plus 9. Next, we'll simplify the exponents. Negative 2 raised to the third power is equal to negative 8. Negative 2 squared would be positive 4. And now we'll multiply. 3 times negative 8 equals negative 24. Here we'll have minus 4 plus 2 times negative 2, that's negative 4, and then plus 9. So now we'll add and subtract from left to right. So negative 24 minus 4, that'll be negative 28. Then negative 28 plus negative 4, that'll be negative 32. And then lastly, negative 32 plus 9 equals negative 23. Let's go and take a look at one more example. Here we have x equals 2 and y equals negative 3. So the numerator will be 2 squared times negative 3 squared over x squared, which would be 2 squared, minus 2 times y to the third will become negative 3 to the third. So what we'll do here is evaluate the numerator and denominator separately, and then lastly simplify the fraction. So 2 squared would be 4, and negative 3 squared would be 9. Our denominator, we're going to have 4 minus 2 times negative 3 cubed is equal to negative 27. Our numerator is going to be 36. In the denominator, we'll have 4 minus negative 54, which will become plus 54. So this fraction is 36 over 58. These both have a common factor of 2. So in simplified form, the fraction would be 18 over 29. I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for watching.